Faith is activated through continuous hearing of God's word. According to Romans chapter 10 verse 17, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Hearing God's word consistently helps you to pray, declaring God's will into your life. It will make you manifest to your world. Get set for an empowerment as the anointed woman of God, Pastor Kemi Balogun, expounds God's will for you. Be connected as you enjoy this timeless message.
This morning we are looking at a topic, growing in faith. Growing in faith. Growing in what? In faith. And you ask me, can my faith grow? Yes. Your faith is a living thing. It's going to grow. Praise the Lord. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, from verse 1 to 3. Paul and Silvanus and Timotheus unto the church of the Thessalonians in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We are bound to thank God always for you, brethren, as it is meet, because that your faith groweth exceedingly, and the charity of every one of you all toward each other aboundeth. Says verse 3, says we are bound to thank God always for you, brethren, as it is meet, because that your faith groweth exceedingly. I will stop at that. The aspect of the charity of every one of you all abound towards each other is another psalm for another day. But let's look at the fact that they give us, the Bible here was talking about giving thanks because our faith is growing exceedingly. So that tells me that our faith has the capacity to grow. And if something has the capacity to grow, it means it also has the capacity to diminish. So, but this morning we want to look at growing in faith. But you've got to be careful that your faith does not diminish. So we want to look at growing in faith. Is your faith growing at all? Or the talk of growing exceedingly? If the Bible is to be written today, can it be written concerning your own faith that we want to thank God that your faith is growing at all, or growing exceedingly, or that your faith is diminishing? Am I seeing rightly? Praise the Lord. So, if the Bible is written today, can it be written that your faith is growing exceedingly? Praise the Lord. The Christian life is a life lived by faith. By faith, you receive Jesus into your life. By faith, you believe that he has come into your life. It is a life lived by faith. By faith, you surrender your life to Jesus. By faith, you go to bed knowing that he's going to watch over you and that you will wake up the next day. The Christian life is a life lived by faith. So if you don't have faith, you cannot live the Christian life. That is why you will see when people are at a point of accepting Jesus, some of them will ask, what do I have to give? You mean there's no sacrifice? You mean there's no concussion? You mean that it's a life lived by faith? Praise the Lord. Everything in the realm of the spirit is appreciated and is received by faith. Salvation is received by faith, is appreciated by faith, is celebrated by faith. Your healing is celebrated by faith, is received by faith, is appreciated by faith. Everything in the life of a Christian is received by faith. The disciples were struggling in the boat. They were struggling, they were almost giving up hope. But meanwhile, Jesus was in that same boat, at the bottom part of the boat, and he was sleeping and snoring. I'm sure that Jesus knew that his time had not come. So he had a great faith that this boat cannot sink. Praise the Lord. No one can prevail by the arms of flesh. So don't put your faith into the arms of flesh. Instead, put your faith in God. Are you among the people that are in the category of no faith? It's time for you to wake up. Because no faith, no living. No faith, no living. Everything will perch on you. Flies, butterfly, mosquito, tetefly, animals, lion, birds will fly on your head and shit there. When you have no faith. No faith, no living. Secondly, Jesus describes some as having little faith. And when you have a little faith, that faith is often shaky. He described them as having little faith. Let's look at Matthew chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6 verse 30. Matthew chapter 6 verse 30. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Oh, you are worried. Oh, they said there's recession here, there's recession there. Oh, there is this. I thank God for the testimony of our brother. Oh, there is this, there is that. But the Bible says, I've never seen the righteous beg for food. So no matter what happens, I'm sure I'm persuaded that I've never seen a righteous beg for food. But Jesus was so angry, says that, all ye of, he says, wherefore if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast unto the oven, he was asking a question, shall he not much more clothe you, all ye of little faith? Shall he not clothe you, feed you, attend to your needs, all ye of little faith? Sometimes we cry, we weep, and we complain, we bombard God with plenty questions, with plenty cries, because we have little faith. And that faith is shaky. You are like, will he do it or not? If you look out and you see him clothing just even the things that are not of great importance, providing food for them, taking care of their needs, how much more you, the child of the living God, the small gods that are here on earth, the little Christ, the representative of Christ here on earth, how much more will he not take care of you? How much more will he not give unto you the things that you need? How much more will he not preserve you from evil? The Bible says in Matthew chapter 16, Matthew chapter 16 verse 8, Matthew 16 verse 8, says, which when Jesus perceived, he said unto them, O ye of little faith, why reason ye among yourselves, because ye have brought no bread? Jesus still speaking there. Again in Matthew 8 verse 26, he said unto them, why are ye fearful? So when you are fearful, it's because you have a little faith. It says, why are ye fearful, O ye of little faith? Why are you fearful? Why are you fidgeting? Why are you shaking? Why are you wavering in what you have asked from God? O ye of little faith. Is Jesus talking to someone in the house this morning? Is your faith little that you are beginning to doubt if God will do it or not? Then it's time for you to grow your faith. If you're having such a little faith, then it's time for you to grow your faith. It's time for you to strengthen your faith. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Oh, and there were some that he called having a great faith, saying that they had great faith. Let's look at Matthew chapter 8, verse 10. Matthew chapter 8, verse 10. When Jesus heard it, he marveled. Whatever will make Jesus to marvel must indeed be a great faith. It says, when Jesus heard it, he marveled and said to them that followed, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. Can you stand to say, Lord, I believe you, and you are rugged with it? Can Jesus come and say, I have found no kind of a great faith like this, even in the whole of Nigeria, in the whole of Africa, in the whole of the Citizens Church? Can Jesus find your faith so great that he can say it out and marvel that I have not found such a great faith like this? Praise the Lord. Look at the book of Luke chapter 7. Look at the book of Luke chapter 7 verse 9. Luke chapter 7 verse 9. And Jesus heard these things. He marveled at him and turned him about and said unto the people that followed him, I say unto you, I have not found so great faith. Again, Jesus speaking. No, not in Israel. Can Jesus marvel at the great depth, at a great level, at a great degree of your faith? He said to some, they have no faith. He said to some, they have little faith and they were afraid. So their faith was as good as useless because fear incapacitated their faith. And he said of some, they have a great faith. What kind of faith will Jesus say that you have in the house? What kind of faith do you have in him? So let's look at how can we grow our faith. How can we grow our faith? How can we grow our faith? Number one, you can ask for help from God. You can ask God for help to grow your faith. You can ask God. Don't try to feel like a champion. Don't try to feel you can do it by yourself. Don't try to just muzzle and do everything. You can ask God to help you. Luke chapter 17 verse 5. Luke chapter 17 verse 5. And the apostles said unto the Lord, increase our faith. Is there someone in the house this morning that wants to speak as the apostles said? And you want to join me to cry unto God and say, Father, increase my faith. Are there people in the house that have not reached the greatest height of faith? And you want to join me and cry out and say, Father, increase my faith. I thought you will shout it dangerously and loudly for heaven to hear you. Father, increase my faith. And so will it be in the name of Jesus.